So good morning students, today we will discuss about the third chapter, current electricity. Now we will discuss about current electricity. So it is a branch of physics which deals with the study of charges in motion is called what? Current electricity. So in this chapter the important concept is very important, electric current, drift velocity of the free electrons and mobility. So first one, electric current. So the flow of electric charge is called what? Current. Or in other words, the time, rate of flow of charges through any cross section area of the conductor is called what? Electric current. The SI unit of electric current is ampere. Then how to define 1 ampere? So if 1 coulomb of charge flowing through a conductor in 1 second, so that is called what? 1 ampere, isn't it? So once again, how to define 1 ampere? If 1 coulomb of charge flowing through a conductor in 1 second, so that is called what? 1 ampere. So the next important concept is drift velocity of the free electrons. The velocity gained by the free electrons in the direction opposite to applied electric field. So that is called what? Drift velocity of the free electrons. So you can see the figure. So these are the electrons, isn't it? So the velocity gained by the free electrons in the direction opposite to the applied electric field, isn't it? So therefore that is called what? Drift velocity of the free electrons. So VD is proportional to E. So next, one mark very important, mobility. So the drift velocity of the free electrons, it depends on the, is directly proportional to the applied electric field, isn't it? Therefore VD is proportional to E. Then we can remove the proportionality, then equal to constant term. So therefore VD divided by E is equal to constant. Then VD divided by E is equal to mu. Then finally, what is meant by mobility means the drift velocity of the free electrons per unit electric field is called what? Mobility. So mobility is denoted by mu. So the SI unit of mobility is SI unit of mobility is, so this is the assignment of the mobility. So these are the very important basic concepts of the current electricity. So once again, so the flow of electric charge is called what? Current. Or in other words, the time, rate of flow of charges through any cross section area of the conductor is called what? Current. The assignment of current is ampere. Then how to define ampere? If 1 coulomb of charge flowing through a conductor in 1 second is called 1 ampere. Next one, drift velocity of the free electrons. So the velocity gained by the free electrons in the direction opposite to the applied electric field. You can see the figure. So the velocity gained by the free electrons is directly proportional to, or in the direction of opposite electric field. So that is called what? Drift velocity of the free electrons. Next one, mobility. So mobility is defined as the drift velocity of the free electrons per unit electric field is called what? Mobility. And write the SI. So next concept is derive an expression for drift velocity of the free electrons. So the expression for drift velocity of the free electrons. Expression for drift velocity of the free electrons. Free electrons. There I have an expression for drift velocity of the free electrons. So again we can see the figure. So consider a conductor of length L having cross sectional area A, across which an electric field is applied, is as shown in the figure. So initially there is no electric field is applied across the conductor. So prarambhadalli ee conductor ge nanu yavade reethiyagirthakkanta current anna pass madilla. Initially there is no electric field applied across the conductor. Then what happens here? The average velocity of the free electrons is zero, that is u is equal to zero. Suppose an electric field is applied across the conductor. What happens here? So the average velocity of the free electrons, it gains the velocity, isn't it, due to the electric field. Therefore V is equal to Vd. So the velocity gained by the free electrons after the relaxation time tau is given by, so therefore you can write T is equal to tau. So the velocity gained by the free electrons after the relaxation time, V is equal to U plus At, isn't it? So initially there is no electric field is applied, so the average velocity of the free electrons is zero, therefore U is equal to zero. So substitute all these values in this equation, then V means what, that is Vd, then U is zero plus A as it is, then T is equal to tau, A tau. So therefore Vd is equal to A tau. So this is equation number one. Once again, initially there is no electric field is applied across the conductor, so the average velocity of the free electrons is zero. Prarambhadalli current ane conductor pass madilla, then NI3 average velocity of the free electrons zero. Suppose an electric field is applied across the conductor, so the velocity it gains, the electrons it gains the velocity due to the applied electric field. So therefore we can write V is equal to Vd, T is equal to tau. So the velocity gained by the free electrons after the relaxation time is given by V is equal to U plus At. U is zero, V is equal to Vd, then T is equal to tau. So this is equation number one, where A is the acceleration gained by the free electrons due to the applied electric field. So therefore you can write F is equal to ma, then A is equal to F by m. So this is equation number 2. So by using Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma, but nanige illen bekagirudu acceleration gained by the free electrons. Therefore A is equal to F by m. Rearrange martta idini. Then where F is the force. So each charge of a dipole and experiences in equal force but in opposite direction. So where in the first chapter torque is placed in an external electric field. So suppose this is a dipole, so this is plus Q and this one is the minus Q. So this is F is equal to plus QV and F is equal to minus QV. Each charge of a dipole experiences an equal force, F is equal to QV, F is equal to QV, but it is in opposite direction, therefore you can write minus QV, isn't it? So therefore directly you can write F is equal to what? QE. Since F is equal to QE, so therefore equation 2 can be written as, so equation 2 can be written as, equation 2 can be written as, therefore A is equal to QE divided by M, where Q is the charge of an electron, isn't it? So therefore Q is equal to what? That is E, where Q is the charge of an electron. So therefore Q is equal to E, then A is equal to E by M. So this is equation number 4. So substitute equation 3 in equation 1. So nanage acceleration gained by the free electron sikto. A is equal to EE by M. So put equation 3 in equation 1. Put equation 3 in equation 1. So therefore equation 1 can be written as VD is equal to EE by M into tau. So this is derive an expression for drift velocity of the free electrons. So once again, what is meant by drift velocity of the free electrons? The velocity gained by the free electrons in the direction opposite to applied electric field. So that is called what, drift velocity of the free electrons. So initially there is no electric field is applied across the conductor. So the average velocity of the free electrons is zero. That is U is equal to zero. Suppose an electric field is applied across the conductor. So the free electrons, it gains the velocity. So V is equal to Vd. So finally, so the velocity gained by the free electrons after the relaxation time tau is given by V is equal to U plus At. So U is 0, V is equal to Vd, T is equal to tau. So substitute all these values in this equation. Then we get the equation 1. So where A is the acceleration gained by the free electrons due to the applied electric field. Therefore, A is equal to F by M. So where F is the force. So each charge of a dipole experiences an equal force but in opposite direction. F is equal to QV and F is equal to minus QV. Therefore, F is equal to QV. So equation 2 can be written as A is equal to QE by M. Where Q is the charge of an electron. So therefore, A is equal to EE by M. So put equation 3 in equation 1. So therefore, finally, we get the drift velocity of the free electrons. VD is equal to EE by M into tau. So next concept is relation between current and drift velocity. Or derive an expression for current in terms of drift velocity. Both are same. So in your examination point of view, so write the relation between current and drift velocity or derive an expression for current in terms of drift velocity. Both are same. Now in my exam ge relation between current and drift velocity antadru kelbodu, or so expression for current in terms of drift velocity antadru kelbodu. So current in terms of drift velocity, in terms of drift velocity R. Expression for current in terms of drift velocity or relation between current and drift velocity. ನಾಳೆ ಹಂಗಾದ್ರೂ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಆದ್ರೂ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಅಗೇನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್, ಇಸ್ಂಟ್ ಇಟ್. So consider a conductor of length L having cross sectional area A, across which a potential difference V volt is applied, then current is flowing through the conductor, isn't it? So therefore the current flowing through the conductor is given by, we can write I is equal to Q divided by T. So this is equation number 1. Once again, consider a conductor of length L having cross sectional area A, across which a potential difference V volt is applied, then current is flowing through the conductor. Therefore, the current flowing through the conductor is given by I is equal to Q by T. So this is equation number 1. So where Q is the total charge flowing through the entire volume of the conductor, isn't it? Where Q Q So where Q is the total charge flowing through the entire volume of the conductor. So therefore where Q is the total charge flowing through the entire volume of the conductor, therefore Q is equal to, so in this conductor number of electrons into volume of the conductor, volume of the conductor, then Q is equal to Ne as it is into volume of the conductor, means what? A and L, area of the cross section of the conductor and length of the conductor L. So this is equation number 2. Now where T is the total time taken by the free electrons, isn't it? Therefore you can write T is equal to L divided by drift velocity of the free electrons. L T is equal to L by VD. So this is equation number 3. So substitute equation 2 and 3 in equation 1. So therefore I is equal to, so Q andre enide illi N E A L divided by T, time taken by the free electrons, L by VD. So you can write L by VD. L and L get cancelled. So VD mele bartada. So then I is equal to N E A VD. So this is the relation between current and drift velocity, or in other words the expression for current in terms of drift velocity of the free electrons. I is equal to N E A VD, isn't it? So this is the relation between current and drift velocity, or current in terms of drift velocity of the free electrons. So next concept is Ohm's law. Ohm's law. So what is the statement of the Ohm's law? So when a current is flowing through a conductor, so that is nothing but I. When a current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference across the end of the conductor, provided temperature and other physical conditions remains constant. So that is the statement of the Ohm's law. I is proportional to V, or V is proportional to I, isn't it? So therefore we can remove the proportionality. V is equal to I R, where R is the constant. That constant is called what? Resistance of the conductor. So V is equal to I R. So this is a statement of the Ohm's law. Once again, when a current is flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference across the end of the conductor, provided temperature and other physical conditions remains constant. So V is equal to I R. So this is the Ohm's law. So then how to derive an expression for the Ohm's law? Then how to prove V is equal to I R? So again, consider a conductor of length L having cross sectional area A, across which a potential difference V volt is applied, then current is flowing through it. Let E be the electric field between the two end of the conductor, is as shown in the figure, isn't it? So therefore current in terms of drift velocity of the free electrons is given by, we can write, already you know, so I is equal to N E A V D. So this is equation number 1, isn't it? So across which a potential difference V volt is applied, then current is flowing through it, isn't it? Therefore I is equal to N E A VD, where VD is the drift velocity of the free electrons, isn't it? Therefore drift velocity of the free electrons is given by VD is equal to small e capital E divided by M into tau. So this is equation number 2. So substitute equation 2 in equation 1. So therefore equation 1 can be written as, so put equation 2 in equation 1. Therefore equation 1 can be written as I is equal to N E A, so E E by M into tau. So next, so I is equal to N E into E, E square A E tau by M. So this is equation number 3. Where E is the electric field between the two end of the conductor. So therefore we can write E is equal to V by L. So this is equation number 4. So substitute equation 4 in equation 3. Therefore equation 3 can be written as I is equal to N E square A V tau by L M. Then rearrange this equation, so cross multiplication ML, then I into ML divided by N E square A tau, kelagade tagontini N E square A tau is equal to ln only V. This whole term is nothing but what? That is resistance of the conductor, that is R. So therefore I R is equal to V, or V is equal to I R. So this is Ohm's law, V is equal to I R. Once again, when a current is flowing through a conductor, it is directly proportional to potential difference across the end of the conductor, provided temperature and other physical conditions remains constant. So finally, we get the V is equal to I R. So this is the Ohm's law. So limitations of the Ohm's law, where it can be applicable for Ohm's law. So Ohm's law, it is only applicable for conductors or ohmic devices. But Ohm's law does not applicable for semiconductors, does not applicable for the insulators, isn't it? So then what is meant by ohmic devices and what is meant by non-ohmic devices? So ohmic devices, these are the devices which obeys the Ohm's law. That is called what? Ohmic devices. Non-ohmic devices means what? So these are the devices which does not obey the Ohm's law. That is called what? Non-ohmic devices. So once again, limitations of Ohm's law. Ohm's law, where it can be applicable. So Ohm's law, it is only applicable for conductors or ohmic devices. So Ohm's law does not applicable for the semiconductors. Ohm's law does not applicable for the insulators. So next class I will continue. So thank you.